There also was a nun, a prioress. Her way of smiling very simple and coy. Her greatest oath was only by St. Loy, and she was known as Madame Eglantine. And well she sang a service, with a fine intoning through her nose, as is most seemly. She could speak daintily in French extremely. After the school of Stratford Atty Bow, French of the Paris kind she did not know. At meat her manners were well taught withal. No morsel from her lips did she let fall, nor wet her fingers in the sauce too deep, lifting the morsel daintily to keep the smallest drop from falling on her breast. For courtly things she had a special zest, and she would wipe her upper lip so clean that not a trace of grease was to be seen left on the cup when she had drunk. To eat, she reached her hand sedately for the meat. And she was certainly most entertaining, and in her amiable manner straining to counterfeit a courtly kind of poise and stateliness of bearing, for the joys of being thought dignified in all her dealings. As for her conscience and her tender feelings, she was so charitably solicitous, she used to weep if she but saw a mouse caught in a trap, if it were dead or bleeding. And she had little dogs she would be feeding with roasted flesh or milk or fine white bread. Sorely she wept if one of them were dead, or someone took a stick to make it smart. She was all sentiment and tender heart. Her veil was gathered in the neatest way. Her nose was elegant, her eyes glass grey. Her mouth was very small, but soft and red, and certainly she had a well-shaped head, almost a span across the brows, I own. Indeed, she was by no means undergrown. Her cloak, I noticed, had a graceful charm. She wore a coral trinket on her arm, a pair of beads, gaudily set in green, whence hung a golden clasp of brightest sheen. This was engraved with a crown capital A, and lower, Amor vincit omnia.